Good morning. I know nobody's watching yet, but say good morning anyway. For anybody watching this video after it's been recorded, well, you just got good morning, even if you're watching this at night. It's time for boot camp. I don't know about you. I just got out of bed and I'm ready to get my day started. I hope you're gonna come join me. And even if you're not, I'm doing this workout. So you notice that we don't have a microphone this week. So give me a little feedback if you can't hear me, if I need to speak up. Farrah's watching the camera. So you can let her know in the comments and she'll let me know up here.
You have Larry, Mary, Linda, Julie, Sharon, Dara, Oliver.
Wow, big crowd. Good morning, everybody.
He's on Dara.
I don't know if I can remember that whole list, but Larry, Julie, Dara,
Sharon.
Mary. Good morning, Mary.
Julie, Linda.
Linda, how's it going? Ready for another round of the workout. So I'm sticking with the workout we did last week.
Deborah.
So you remember from the first week, I like to do one workout for a few weeks. Or one, you want to get used to it. You want to, I think, you know, I really have the goal of teaching a little bit. So we're, like I said, this is basic training. We'll work on push-ups, we'll work on lunges, you know, the crisscross exercise. But I really want you to spend some time on the technique and learning the value of going slow, taking your time. You know, in years of training and teaching, it's real common to have clients and little kids and students who want to be good right now. They want to go fast. They want to be able to do it immediately. And sometimes there's a little psychology that happens when they can't. And so I find myself spending a lot of time coaching. Slow down. Take your time. Be really paying attention to the technique first. And then once you find that you can do the technique correctly, you can speed up. Now I know as adults, we probably all know that, but I can admit in my own self that I don't always follow that advice. But it helps to be reminded once in a while. So as just to reiterate, we're gonna take our time with the technique today. This isn't about going fast. It's about doing your best to be correct and do it slow. We're focusing on negative work with the push-ups quite a bit. Everything is a slow descent and with a quick or as quick as you can manage lift, especially on those push-ups. We've got a 5-minute warm-up. We'll get started with that in just a second, but just to review the whole tech, the whole workout, we're doing four rounds. Each round, it consists of three exercises. We do each exercise for 1 minute. We got a 45-second rest, and then we cycle back through that series before we move on to the next workout, right? So it's four rounds of basically six exercises each, right? Done twice, three exercises done twice. First round is push-ups, regular vanilla push-ups. I'll talk a little about the technique when we do them. Followed by the bicycle or the crisscross, laying on your back, opposite elbow touching opposite knee, and then the low, slow step back, which is basically just a step back lunge, but staying down in the crouch. And then we'll move on to the next series after we finish that, each of those twice. All right, if you're ready, Farrah's gonna start our timer. You're gonna hear a beep at the transitions. So at every minute, and then 45 seconds on the rest, you'll hear a beep that'll let you know. Counts us off at 10, we get the 3-second countdown, and then we switch. So start with your warm up. I'm gonna start out with one of my favorite moves, which is just simply lifting my knees and bringing my opposite elbow across, right? And I like to make my warm-up moves simulate some of the exercises we're gonna do during the workout. So this is applying a principle, right? Specificity, fancy words. Just means that the closer our moves are to what we're trying to do, the closer the benefit is. So if I'm warming up, I make my warm-up moves kind of like my exercise moves. Now I'm not going for any specific time. I just want to go to get warm. I'm glad you're all here. You know, I was thinking about something this especially after watching behind the camera last week. I'm going to take it down, right? I'm just going to go arm swing. So I'm going to open my arms wide, palms facing the front, and then close them. Just crisscrossing, alternating. You know, in the world of fitness and, well, for that matter, entertainment, there's all this really well-produced, well-rehearsed material out there. And I've always thought that the only problem with that material is that it often doesn't look real. It looks fake. You know, I've been noticing something about all the things that we're doing right now with the JCC and all this virtual fitness. One arm up, one arm down, right? Just like that. I'm pushing this arm back, and I'm just going to alternate, right? Switching. Nice and easy. I think that what you're getting from your fitness staff here, jumping on board with all this virtual fitness, is something real. You're getting real heart, real emotion, real work. Sometimes real frustration. I kind of like it. It's actual reality TV right there in your living room, broadcast from somebody else's living room. All right, good. Now give me a twist, right? Rotating the body. Remember, we're warming up just to get things moving. I want your blood flowing. I want you feeling loose. But your warm up should make you feel, well, warm. So if you get done with a warm-up and you don't really feel like your body's getting ready to sweat, go back to lift your knees up, but I'm going to lift them up in the back, right? So I'm doing a little alternate. I'll do this from the front, right? Stepping from side to side. I'll put my hand back there to kick my heel. Add a little arm movement. You should feel like you're on the verge of breaking a sweat, right? Get that warm. If you're not fully there before the time we start this workout, after the first round, you should be there. So you can also use that first round as a little bit of a warm-up. All right, good. Now stand, take a nice stance. Bend your knees. Sink down low and then come back up. Right, doing a little squat. I'm going for a wide stance. It's okay to be a little narrower than this. You might see a cat pass by once in a while this morning. Lately, they've been staying out of the camera, though. I think maybe they're a little hurt by some of the comments they've been getting. And then let's take this into a little side-to-side shift. So I'm going to straighten and shift from one side to the other. I'm going to put my hands on my knees as I'm shifting. I've got my toes turned out a little bit. Just allow the knees to move freely. So when I shift to one side, I open the knee up. Pointed over the toe, side to side. We've got about a minute left of the warm-up before we start. So just to review, the first post, the first set, regular push-ups. We're doing, I think, like 4 or 5 second push-ups, right? You're going down for 3 or 4 seconds and up on one. Always emphasizing that downward move. Go on back, shake your legs out. Then we switch over after a minute, right to a crisscross, opposite elbow, opposite knee, abs. Followed by a low, slow step back, which is getting into a crouch, going back into a lunge, and then coming forward without coming all the way up. We're going to stay down. Right? Remember, when you're doing those lunges, try to keep your body upright. A little bit of ab bracing. I know we say that a lot, brace the core. But that means just tensing up in the middle a little bit. All right. Are you ready? I'm going to get down for my push-up. Remember, hands even with the shoulders, elbows slightly to the back. All right, assume the position, down slow, and then you pop up. And remember, you can always modify. You can start right on the knees, down slow. Now, when I was in boot camp, these were always 5 set push-ups. All right, it was down, 2, 3, 4, and then 1 second up. Down, 2, 3, 4, and then up. Now notice the lowering, right? The body is one straight line. My head isn't dipping down first. All the movement is at the shoulders and the elbows. Everything else is firm. If I do this from the knees, right? The body from the knees to the shoulders is a straight line. So I'm not set, I'm not bent this way, the hips. Down, slow, press up. Emphasize the descent. Focus on the negative. So one timer, I'll tell you, thinking about the negative is actually Good for you. All right. Flip it over for that crisscross. Remember, we switch and hold for a moment. I'm emphasizing length. I want to push the foot across the room. And I want to rotate my body nice and far. So every one of these reps should have some serious effort in it. Breathe with every twist. If you can regulate your breathing, you're going to find that you move a little more freely. Holding your breath or gasping for air, those will tend, right, to make it harder to move. Never mind, feel terrible. So a little exhale, which means I'm inhaling as I'm switching, right? Breathing in and then exhaling. We got 10 seconds of this before we get up and go to the low, slow step back. Here we go. So, in the crouch, stepping back to the lunge and then coming back up and staying low. I'm going to do this on an angle so you can see it. Make sure I'm in the shot. You can let Farrah know if I leave the shot, but I think I know where I'm at. So, trying to stay in that crouch. The whole idea here is to keep the tension in the leg muscles, especially the quads and the glutes. And again, this is slow. So the pace is up to you. Remember what I was saying before about rushing. If you do these exercises faster, they'll still be tiring, right? Don't get me wrong. You're still working. But you might be losing something on the technique, right? And when we're going slow, we can concentrate on alignment. My hip, my knee, and my ankle are all in line with each other. Not only in the leg in front, but the one in back. All right, we got a 45 second rest. You got a minute to get some water. First round is over. Not so bad, right? Now, if you're doing this regularly enough, and I know a couple people commented, they've done this a few times already, notice some improvement. And that's good. You should feel improvement, right? And I want you to try to notice that, right? See a difference between what you did from week to week if you do the same routine. Remember what I said the first time we did this, benchmarking. Give yourself something that you can use to track your progress. We got 10 seconds. Remember when you're warming up, or when you're cooling down or resting, it's an active rest. You should be moving. All right, back to the push-up. Regular vanilla push-ups. So down, slow, use that negative, right? That time is all about the technique. I am really doing my best to force my body to stay in good form. That's what going slow allows you to do, is to notice, oh wow, my back is sagging, or my butt's sticking up, or my head's going down first. Notice that, look at my head. It stays up. I'm actually looking a little bit ahead of me. It helps me maintain a good neck position. So my eyes are looking out here ahead of me on the floor, just a little. I'm not looking straight up like this, right? Just slightly ahead. The chest gets to the ground before anything else. It doesn't have to touch. Unless, remember, you've hit that failure point, in which case you can lay on the ground, work yourself back up, and then do the negative. All right, flip it over for the crisscross. So reaching, twisting. Now, there's nothing wrong with going a little faster. What I often say to my kids in my karate classes, and I might say this to you too, the correct speed is the fastest you can do correctly. Now, in our workout right now, I'm deliberately telling you to emphasize the slow movement, but if you're doing good form, you could go a little faster if you feel it. But your job today is to be strict with yourself, right? You're making yourself slow down. Emphasize the technique, right? I am really gripping with my abs right now, pulling them in to try to hold my body up. And I'm slowing it down so I can think about my breathing. All right, we're up for the low, slow step back. So stay in that crouch. Now I've got my hands here on my legs, but I'm not really using them. You could also hold them out in front of you. If you wanted to be a little more difficult with this, you can put your hands back here. We call this the prisoner position. So if you've ever done something like a prisoner squat, we could call this the prisoner lunge. Right, trying to stay in that crouch. Keep the load in the legs. Right, if you need to rest, you can pause for a second in the down position. You could stand up, take a second, shake the legs out before you go back to it. Again, the hand position is a variation. I can put my hands down here on my hips. If you need to do something to maintain balance, right, because this is about the legs. I want my upper body posture square, but. All right, 45 seconds of rest. Now we switch to post two. Post two, we got two rounds. We do the wide arm push-up now with the legs spread apart. Call that a Spider-Man push-up. But the same idea, same rules apply here with the arms wide. Watch out for your head being behind your elbows. Okay, so if you picture me down on my hands and knees or down on the floor with my hands wide, I am not going up here. Okay, I go out wide and I like to turn my hands out. Okay, palms face to the outside. Then we're going to switch to some reverse curls and some single leg thrusts. Right, here we go. Wide push up. See how my hands and my fingers are turned to the outside. For me, I find that allows me to really emphasize pressing into the heel of my palm. So, nice wide grip, feet spread apart. I'm going down to that push-up. Same slow pace, right? Negative, 3 or 4 seconds, 1 second up. Take your time. The longer you spend, right, down in that low position, hovering, holding the form, the more work you get in the pecs. And I can really emphasize the pecs in this position, right? It's a little less tricep, a lot more chest muscle, if you're doing it correctly, right? If you're aligned correctly. So watch what you feel in your shoulders. If you're feeling a lot of strain here, there's something you're doing wrong in your position, okay? Or you're hurt, in which case, knock it off, right? Remember, you can always put the knees down, do that push-up from here. All right, flip it over. This is reverse curl. I'm gonna slip my hands under my hips, right? And the head stays down. I'm going to press up, and then slowly lower myself back down to the start position. The hands can be under the hips or next to the hips, depending on what you need for your lower back. Since we're not going down here, we should be putting a lot less load on the lower spine, so you should be all right. But if you do feel anything here, lower back, slip your hands right under your hips like that for a little support. Either way, fight your way down slow. Try to keep the back of your head on the mat. One tip, depending on what's happening with your neck, you could put a pillow or a yoga block or something under here, but you've got to make sure that the weight of your upper body is not on your neck, but on your upper back. So when I come up into that curl, all right, we're on our feet. I'm sorry, no, you stay on your back. Right, lift one leg up. We do 5 thrusts, single leg thrusts. And then we switch once we do 5, and we do 5 on the other side, and we keep alternating 5 at a time. Now try your best, if you remember last week, to use your own muscle power to hold this knee in. I'm not pulling with my hands. I'm trying to pull that knee in tight. I want you to do 5, switch legs. At the top of this lift, really contract the glute. Remember to dig your heels in. And I like to lift my toes off the mat. It's not necessary, but I find it helps me emphasize the heel. And if you lose count every now and then, that's okay. You got 10 seconds to go. And then I'll switch in one more. All right, we got a 45 second rest. I'm gonna finish 5 reps here before I go into the rest, just so I balance it out. All right, little recovery. So, quick review. Spider-Man, wide arm, wide leg push-up, followed by reverse curl, followed by thrust, single leg hip thrust. So to go back to that push-up for a second, making sure you're not really straining your shoulder joint when you're doing a push-up. Keep moving, by the way, all right? As you're resting, you should be letting your body recover, right? You just want to, you want to keep things moving. I want to line things up, hands a little below shoulder level, so that when I'm down in that push-up, I'm not pushing into the shoulder joint. I want to feel it here in the pecs, right? So if you drop down low and you feel your chest muscles really loading up, you're doing it right. You're in that wide push-up, right? If you're dropping down here and you're feeling stress or strain in your shoulder or your neck, then you might just be tightening the neck muscles. But that might mean your alignment is a little off, right? So you might have to change your hand position a little bit to see if you can create a position that really targets the chest muscle more effectively. Now, don't get me wrong. My shoulder muscles are doing some work. So I don't want you to think you shouldn't feel anything in your shoulder. But there's a difference between muscle stress from work and the strain and stress from being out of position. They really do feel different. Ooh, yes. Are you breathing? All right, reverse curl. Remember, slow. So, curl up. So right here in this position, I've got my hands down, but notice my head is free. That lets me know that the weight is really in my upper back and not pressing into my head. Right now, it's not terribly bad to do that, unless you've got some neck problems. And I really don't want you to load your neck up. Oh. One of the ways to help regulate that is by really pressing down on the floor with your arms. So see, my arms are straight, pressing down. That also very nicely loads up the tricep. Curl down, breathe out. Fighting my way down. Again, on the way down, I am really trying my best to pull with my abs in addition to everything else, right? Keeping my head free, fighting with the abs. All right, here's that single leg thrust, five at a time. Right, at the top of that lift, feel that glute, put your hands right on it. Right, you're alone there, right? There's nobody watching. Reach down there, grab it, feel that muscle tightening up at the top of that lift. And then you can add a little to it, right? I'm actually trying to flex it. Once you do five, switch legs. Little hip thrusts like this. There are some fun ways you can add a little resistance to this, right? You can have a weight across your hips. You can do it with some bands, although that's a little more complicated. Five at a time. Don't forget about the rest of the body posture here. I'm still reaching with my arms. I've still got my neck nice and long. Trying not to put a lot of pressure on the back of the head, right? I'm letting it rest on the floor. Ugh. All right, we switch to post three. So post three, diamonds. Keep moving while you're resting. All right, the diamonds are a great exercise, but it's challenging. Hands close under the chest. Not under the face. I've seen people do this where they're lowering their nose in here. Now I want you to go chest. This makes the pecs work hard, but it really makes the triceps work hard. So remember, you can do this one from the knees, right? Lowering down. See the position of the elbows, right? They're going backwards and out to the side. They are not going forward like this, right? Friends, do me a favor. If you see anybody you know doing push-ups like that, slap them. Or at least say something to them to let them know they're doing something harmful to their shoulders, right? Down, up, ugh. So remember, you can drop slow. Do that with your body and then drop, get on the floor, get yourself up. I don't care if you can't lift yourself up from this position. I want you fighting your way down all the way. If you can do this part, great. If not, no big deal. You just focus on that negative work. Notice, by the way, I've got my feet far apart. That will help with the stability. So even if I do this from the knees are wide. I'm rocking from the knees, right? Keeping the body straight. Trying to keep my head in that position. I know when you're struggling, things start falling apart.
the next thing you know, you're sagging your head and you're going down part way and you're doing something like this, right? Right, fight against that. All right, planks. So this is going down to the hover, elbow to elbow, back up again, and then doing four plank jacks. Right, so it's elbow, elbow, hand, hand, and then one, two, three, four. Elbow and elbow, hand in hand. So the goal here is to try to keep the hips pretty steady. So when I drop down, I don't want to do this and this. See how my hips did a lot of shifting? And then when I come up, it's like this. No. What I want to do is try to keep my hips as level as I can. So when I drop down, oh, right? See how the hips stayed pretty level. Same thing coming up. That's hard work. I know. But that's what we're here to do. It slows things down. If you get that already, that's the theme. All right, multi-directional lunges. So we lunge to the front. Then we lunge to the back. Then we lunge to the side. And then we lunge across, all with the same leg. Then we switch. Front, back, right, side, and then curtsy. A lot harder for me on that leg with that hip. Oops, slow. Emphasize the balance. Uh-oh, I'm doing the wrong one.
You're right.
That's all right. And then four, and then curtsy. I just realized I put the wrong leg exercise in the wrong set. That's fine though. We'll just switch to the next one in the last set. Remember, you got a 45 second rest right here. Okay. Remember what I said, reality. I'm really in my living room. You're really in your living room. There's not a bunch of producers around. There's nobody feeding me lines. There's no makeup artist here. Nobody's fixing my hair. It's real. The real thing. Never thought reality TV was real anyway. All right, just about 15 seconds. So, to review, diamonds, shoulder position, right? Watch out for this. If your elbows are up here past your ears, you are potentially injuring your shoulder. So stay low with those elbows. Here we go. Down slow, and then press up. I love diamonds. Really tremendous development. Emphasize that body position on the way down, though, right? Again, so if you get stuck down here, you just get back up, and then you fight your way down with a straight body. If you still have some of that positive push in you, right, you can do it. You're about halfway through this set. Don't be afraid to make some noise, right? Grit your teeth, grunt. There's nobody else in the room with you. They don't care if you're making some noises. We might say something if you're doing that in the gym. I've had to talk to a few people over the years. All right. So elbow to elbow, right, hover plank, plank jack. So starting down low, coming back up, and then four jacks. So steady and level with the hips. I don't care how fast you go, I want you to go slower so you fight with the hip position, right? Keep them stable. Remember, by the way, to alternate which arm you drop down first. Such good work. Focus. Take your time. If you need to rest, you take a second off. And then you get right back to it. Right? That's okay. All right. So back to the multi-directional lunge.
Front first, back. I've got to make sure I don't step back into one of my motivational signs behind me. Side, and then cross. Front, coming right at you. Back, side, cross, slow down. So while you're doing these lunges and you're going slow, you've got lots of time, lots, to focus on the alignment. Do each move methodically. Try your best to keep your knees and your hips and your feet lined up with each other with every step. Uh-oh. Might have time for one more set here. All right, 45 seconds of rest and we go on to set three. Set three. Here's my reality. I've got to switch some things around. Cobra push-up. I know you liked this one last time, right? Just a quick review. The cobra push-up is starting in that kind of down dog position, diving your head straight down to the mat and then scraping along the floor, bringing your chest along, coming up. And then here's the hard part, is going back in reverse. Bring it down, push yourself back into that position, okay? Woo! It's good work, right? So we do cobra push-ups. We do extension, right? So we're on all fours, alternating one side to the other. And then we're doing a low horse jack, right? So cobra push-ups, you got a minute. It also helps to do these with your feet far apart. You're going through these slow and methodical. You're not resting in any one position for too long. Woo! If you need rest, well, here's a good place to rest. Rest in a position that's actually a little bit of work. Are you gritting your teeth a little bit? Are you fighting through this? Remember, if you can't do it, you're doing part of that movement, say to here, then you can just shift back, come up, and then repeat. You could do a knee version of this, right? From the knees, and then back. All right, we are doing alternating extension. So you're on all fours, opposite arm, opposite leg, and then underneath your body, pull your elbow and your knee together, and then extend back. I'm gonna do five. Again, reaching long, and then I'm going to switch sides. Right, opposite arm, opposite leg, crunch up in the middle, and then open that body up and extend. Try to get your hand and your foot level with your body, right? Hand level to shoulder, foot level to hip. Even a little bit of extra lift is okay. If you can do it, hold that position for a moment before you switch. Sweat starting to drip onto my carpet. I realize I'm doing four at a time here. That's okay. All right, low horse jack. So that is down, opening up wide, coming back together, alternating. The word I'm looking for is to step and step and then step together. Otherwise, you're jumping out and you're jumping in. And again, we're staying in a partial crouch. So I'm never coming back up all the way. Here was my one exception to going a little faster. Notice something about this. When I open up, I'm actually turning my feet to the outside and opening the knees. And when I come in, right, they line back up again. Watch out for banging your knees together here. Stay in that low position. And in this case, lower is more work. You got 10 seconds before you have a rest. And then we got one more set. Okay, 45 seconds of recovery. Of course, we'll have to wait and see if Farah tries to throw any surprises at us. I don't think she'll do it. I think I think she's going to sit there and not say a word. Alright, so remember, quick review. Cobra push-ups, followed by alternating extensions on all fours, right? Opposite arm and leg. Followed by the low horse jack. You got 10 seconds. You might want to get in the position. Here we go. Down, scrape the ground. Right, I don't want you to be on the ground. I want you to come close. Oh boy. That is some good work, right? Down, scraping the ground with my nose, then my chin, then my chest. I'm coming up into that cobra position. And then, here we go. Drop it down. Look at that, I'm hovering. Push straight back. Bottoms up. And then we repeat. Remember the options here. To put the knees down, you can do this position from the knees. Right, move through, come up, get down into that hover, not touching the ground, push straight back and into that position. Or you can do this part, fight your way down, put your knees down, shift back, and then repeat on the downward move. All right, opposite arm and leg extension. Let's do them four at a time. Remember that crunch in the middle, opposite elbow, opposite knee, and extend. Uh-oh. Farrah's writing down notes behind the camera. I bet you can hear that pen scratching. She doesn't think we've done enough work. Right, again, I switched to four at a time. The number's not so important. Again, it's going slow, emphasizing your technique. All about trying to fight for a stable body position here at the top, right? Everything's lengthened, everything's held in place. I don't see what you wrote. All right, low horse jacks. So I'm gonna start wide, bring them in, bring them out. So you set your pace here. But again, I'm much more interested in seeing you emphasize your technique in your position each rep, right? And make the work happen through that practice rather than going faster. So you're really studying your body, right? Hips, knees, feet lined up. Is something out of whack here? Fix it, right? But you can't do that if you're going fast. So this is your time to be methodical, to be technique focused. And I always tell you, as a coach and a trainer, that you should start almost everything you do like this, right? Focus on that technique. You got 10 seconds. Get the technique down, then you develop speed. All right. We got a 45-second rest, but here's what we're going to do. Much like last week, Farrah has awarded us some bonus material. So here's the goal. Everything I just said about going slow, throw it out the window. Here's your homework. 10 burpees, 20 mountain climbers, 50 jumping jacks, and then you're done, right? Let me say it again. 10 burpees, 20 mountain climbers, 50 jumping jacks, and then done. Here's what I want you to do. When you're done, you're going to write done in the comments. Farrah's going to keep track of when we get done. I feel pretty confident that most of you guys are going to be done before me. Right? We'll call it a race. We'll do our best shot. Now, I know you could be sitting there waiting. How long will that take? And then just type done when you think you're going to be first. I trust you guys. It's your workout anyway. All right. Are we ready? I'll tell you when to start. Quick review. 10 burpees, 20 mountain climbers, 50 jumping jacks in that order. Ready? Check your space. Check your neighbor. Set. Go. 1, 2, 3.
3. 4. I'm touching my ceiling every time. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 20. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5. 10. I'm done. Are you done? Are you still going? That's good. All right. When you finish, you have finished the workout. How we doing? Anybody done yet? Are you guys still going? Anybody type done before I finish? No? Vera, you can talk. They can hear you.
There's a delay.
There's a delay. Oh, right. All right. Right. There's like a 30-second or more delay between me doing this and you seeing it. And then you typing a comment and then it coming back to me. So there's a flaw in the system. Remember what I said? Reality TV. All right, listen, we've got planks with Pete coming up. I want to reiterate something Farrah said to you guys last week, for those of you that are watching, and for that matter, anybody who watches this later on. Really, really want to give you guys a lot of heartfelt thank you for being out there watching us. It really is motivating. It's motivating me to do more work, and it also helps in a really crazy time to feel like there's a little reality still happening, right? Right? Something that's not produced, not covered in makeup, not fed a bunch of lines. No, real, honest interaction with real people. I love you guys. Thanks so much for being here. And have fun with Planks with Pete. I'll see you next week. Have a great day.